The concept of minute spaces difference, right? Minute spaces difference. Now, this has nothing much to do with the calculation. It's a very simple understanding. What you have to remember, the 1 minute, see, in the entire clock, if you look at the minutes, right, the entire clock is divided into 60 minutes, okay? The entire clock is divided into 60 minutes and the total angle is 360 degree. So clearly 1 minute is clearly equivalent to 360 degree divided by 60, which is 6 degree, right? So 1 minute space, 1 minute space is actually equal to 6 degree angle. That's it. Nothing else. So if I say 3 minute space, right, if I say 3 minute space, that will be equal to 3 into 6 degree, which is 18 degree angle. Okay, let's say when I say the hands are together, if the hands are together, what is the minute space difference between them? So as you know, the hands together means angle is 0. So 0 angle. Now 0 angle would mean 0 minute space. Alright, let's say if I have hands opposite to each other, hands opposite. Now, when the hands are opposite, the angle between them, the value is 180 degree. Here we take the final value, 6 degree, final positive value, right? Here the angle doesn't come negative. Okay, so 180 degree. Now, 180 degree, 6 degree is 1 minute. So, 180 degree will be equal to 180 by 6, that is 30 minutes. All right. So, when the hands are opposite, they are 180 degree angles apart. And there are 30 minutes, there are 30 minute space or 30 minute difference apart, right? So when I say 30 minute apart, it means they are at, they are opposite to each other, right? When I say at right angle, hands at right angle, what does that mean? When they're at right angle, the angle is 90 degree. So this 90 has to be equal to 90 by 6, 90 by 6, that is 15 minute apart, right? So try and understand this. When I say the hands are at right angle, that means the angle between them is 90 degree and they are 15 minutes apart in terms of minute space difference. All right. So I think we have done quite a lot of theory. Let's take up some questions now. Now this first question, it says, what is the ratio of 18 minutes to 1 hour, right? So 18 minutes to 1 hour. First of all, whenever we take ratio, we have to make sure that they are in same units. So it is 18 minute divided by 1 hour is 60 minute. All right. So minute cancel, it is 18 by 60. Now you can simplify 6 threes are and 6 tens are. So the answer is 3:10, right? A simple question. Second question, in 16 minutes, the minute hand gains over the hour hand, all right? See, it is the angle that is the question asking, okay? In 16 minutes, the minute hand gains over the hour hand, the angle, we have to find the angle, okay? Now let's see, in 1 minute, what happens? In 1 minute, Our hand travels half degree, because the speed is half degree per minute. Minute hand travels 6 degree, because the speed of minute hand is 6 degree per minute. So in every 1 minute, the gain by minute hand over our hand is equal to 6 minus half, that is 11 by 2 degree. That's it. So in this question, in 16 minutes, the minute hand gains over the hour hand, that means that required angle gain is straight away equal to 16 into 11 by 2. Please understand, in every 1 minute, it is 11 by 2 degree per minute. It is basically the relative speed. So in 16 minutes, it will be 16 into 11 by 2. 2 cancels 16 8 times. 8 into 11 is 88 degree. So 88 degree in 16 minutes. That's it. In every 1 minute, the minute hand will gain 6 minus half per minute. 6 minus half degree per minute. So in 16 minutes, 16 into 11 by 2. Right? Which is 88 degree gain. Okay. Let's take up the next question. Now, this question says a clock is started at noon. That means 12 o'clock. By 10 minutes past 5. Now 10 minutes past 5, the time is 5:10. Right? Question is, the hour hand has turned through. Again, the question is about angle. What is the angle through which the hour hand has turned? Now there are two ways to do it. One is, let's find the net time or the total duration. What is the total duration from here to here? Right? From 12 o'clock to 5:10. The total duration is 5 hours, 10 minutes. If you convert all of them into minutes, it will be 5 into 60, 1 hour is 60 minutes, plus 10 minutes, which is 310 minutes. The speed of our hand is equal to half degree per minute. So very clearly, the angle traveled by the hour hand will be straight away equal to speed half degree per minute into the time 310 minutes. So this is the answer will be 155 degree. All right. The other way to do is look at the exact situation, right? At 12 o'clock, you can see that the hour hand is here only at 12, right? At 5, it must have reached 5, and at 5:10, it has gone a little ahead, right? So this total angle between 12 and 5, it is simply 5 into 30, because for every 1 hour, the angle will be 30 degree. So 5 into 30 is 150 degree. Then in the next 10 minutes, this small angle, right? This is 10 minutes and speed of hour hand is 5, a half degree per minute. So it is simply 10 into half, which is 5 degree. So the total angle traveled will be 155 degree. Whichever way you like, you can do this. Okay. Now the next one, it says an accurate clock shows 8 o'clock in the morning. Through how many degrees will hour hand rotate when the clock shows 2 o'clock in the morning? And it is again about hour hand. Now this is 8 o'clock in the morning. Now what is the situation at 8 o'clock? 8 o'clock, the hour hand is at 8, right? This is the minute hand situation at 8 o'clock. Similarly, at 2 o'clock, what will happen? The hour hand, minute hand is still here at 12 and the hour hand is at 2, right? So what has happened? The hour hand has traveled from 8 to 2, right? Now from 8 to 2, 4 and 2, 6 hours. Right, it is simply 6 hours. For every 1 hour, it is 30 degrees. So it is simply 30 into 6, that is 180 degree. Alright. So every 1 hour, our hand travels 30 degrees. So for 6 hours, see, from 8 to 2 o'clock, from 8 to 2 o'clock, the duration is of 6 hours. 8 o'clock in the morning, 8 o'clock in the morning to 2 o'clock in the afternoon. Okay, it is afternoon. So 6 hours. Every 1 hour, 30 degree. So 6 hours into 30 degree, it is 180 degree. That is the angle traveled by the hour hand. Okay. Now let's go to the next question. Now this question says, in every 60 minutes, the minute hand gains so many minutes on the hour hand. We have already seen that the angle gain in 1 minute is equal to 11 by 2 degrees. All right. Now, we also know that 1 minute gain is equal to 6 degree, right? The minute difference is 1 minute is 6 degree. So that means 1 degree will be equal to 1 by 6 minute. Okay. So if I want to calculate angle gain in 1 minute in terms of minute, so what do I need to do is we need to take this 11 by 2 divide by 6. So 11 by 2 degree difference will become equal to 11 by 2 by 6 minute difference. So it is 11 by 12 minutes. All right. So in every one minute, the angle gain is 11 by 2 degree and the time gain is 11 by 2 minutes. So in every 60 minutes, right? So in 60 minutes, the minute hand gains how many minutes? 60 into 11 by 12 minutes, right? So 12 cancels 60 5 times. 5 into 11 is 55 minutes. So we can also say that in every one hour, minute hand gains 55 minutes on hour hand. You know, you can simply take the situation of 12 o'clock and 1 o'clock and you can see. Okay. Let's say at 12 o'clock, the minute hand and hour hand both are at this place. Right. But at 1 o'clock, hour hand is here, minute hand is here. Right. So as you can see, this is 5 minute gap and this total is 55 minute gap. So they are 55 minutes apart. So minute hand gains 55 minutes on the hour hand in a duration of 1 hour. And duration of 1 minute, the gain is of 11 by 12 minutes. All right. Now, the next one, oh, this we have already done. It says when the hands are in the opposite direction means the angle is 180 degree. Now, how many minute spaces? So 180 degree will be equal to 180 by 6, that is 30 minute spaces. This we have already done. So when they are opposite, they are 30 minute spaces apart. Okay. Now let's go to the next question. Now the seventh one. Oh, this also we have done. When the two hands are at right angle, they are how many minute spaces apart? Right. So how many minute spaces apart? We have already seen that. So right angle means angle 90 degree. So angle 90 degree would straight away mean 90 divided by 6, that is 15 minute spaces apart. Alright, minute spaces apart. So whatever is the angle divided by 6, that's it. That is the minute spaces apart. Now at what time between 5 and 6 o'clock are the hands of a clock are 3 minutes apart? Now this is very interesting. 3 minutes apart, if you convert in angle, it will be equal to 3 into 6 degree, which is 18 degree. So basically the question becomes, at what time between 5 and 6, the angle between minute hand and hour hand is 18 degree. Now 18 degree can be in two ways. It is either plus 18 degree or minus 18 degree. Okay. So what we will do is we'll take two, both the situations. We have the formula theta equal to 30 into H minus 11 by 2 M. So if I take first one, that is plus 18, so 18 equal to, first hour is 5, so it is 30 into 5 minus 11 by 2 m. So from here we have 30 into 5 is 150, 18 goes to the other side, gets subtracted. So 11 by 2 m equal to 150 minus 18, which is 132. So 11 m by 2, that is 132, so we have m equal to 132 into 2 divided by 11. Now 11 cancels 132 12 times, so m is equal to 24. Right, so the first moment is straight away 524. When there are 3 minute spaces, see, when they are apart, we don't know which one is ahead. Okay, so we have to take both the cases, right? So it is 524. When minute hand is behind, that means plus angle. When minute hand is ahead, that means minus 18. Right. Now let's take the second situation, minus 18, we have to use the same formula. Okay, so minus 18 is equal to 30 into 5 minus 11 by 2 m. So 11 by 2 m is equal to 30 into 5 is 150, 18 added, so plus 18, that gives us 168. So we have m equal to 168 into 2, that is 334, right? 336 by 11. So m is equal to 36 by 11. That means the moment will be 536 by 11. That is the time when the minute hand and hour hand are at a gap of 18 degree. Okay, so one moment is 524, the other moment is 536 by 11. All right. So I think this is where we have completed some of the good questions. Now we'll take up the next concept.